Lanka, a once prosperous land ruled by the wealthy King Kubera, now stands robbed and overthrown by a tyrant king, Ravana. Women from all corners of the earth are being snatched against their will to satisfy Ravana's lust and perverted thrills.
放开我！你们的首领在哪里？ 如果你们的首领很厉害的话， 为什么不能出来见我们？ 我们一定会为我们自己而战的。
I was only beginning to witness Lanka's sad state of affairs. But however much I want to, I cannot yet interfere. For the reason I was here, well, for matters else. For a dear friend, Lord Rama, I had promised to help. His beloved wife has been missing for almost a year. A matter no loving couple could ever bear.
Не волнуйся. Они говорят, что... Равана не может никого насиловать. Ему нужно их согласие. Это потому, что есть проклятие. Однажды Равана попытался приставать к девушке по имени Видавати. Чтобы спастись, она подожгла себя, проклиная его последними словами. Что, если он снова попытается изнасиловать девушку? Он загорится и умрет. Говорят, что после этого проклятия он боится кого-либо насиловать.
All clues pointed towards Lanka's tyrant king. If I find the princess here, the hellish planets will shudder at the havoc I will bring.
My only sister is dead. Curse you, Ravana, you filthy pig! May your wives, land, and riches burn before your very eyes!
You may wonder just exactly, who am I? My feats have made even Yama, the god of death, cry. I have acquired many names over my long life. But none of those matter to me any longer. I am the servant of Rama, here to help find his wife. The aura was dark everywhere I turned, for men had abandoned righteousness, with lust they burned. Lust leads to greed, greed leads to anger, anger leads to suffering, which was clear amongst Ravana's Lanka. As soon as I saw her, I knew it was Sita. I was looking at a divine soul, the universe beneath her.
Every living being is a fragment of the ultimate. There is the supreme soul and the energy force of nature. That nature is feminine. Never undermine your own nature as a female. The soul doesn't have a gender. I hope that makes you happy for the morning.
Although her distress of separation from Rama was clear, her golden aura radiated more than the gold-paved city for which she didn't seem to care.
Sita, the way you talk of Rama almost makes us fall in love with him too. We have never heard of such an ideal man, ideal king, ideal husband. Where you left off last was where you stayed in the forest and saw the golden deer. Do tell us more. Sister, the very day I saw the golden deer was the very fateful day I saw Lord Rama for the last time. When I saw the deer, I was hypnotized with desire. Desire of ownership, the very trait that leads to one's downfall. My loving Rama went to catch it for me. That's when you're king.
Upon seeing Ravan, I realized what had become of him. This was a man who had fallen to his own ego.Beauty of all beauties, whose face glows more radiantly than the sunrise by this tree. If only you would look at me, I would make all my wives your handmaidens immediately. Oh, why does she not see this handsome Ravan and his might and put up this unnecessary fight? Darling, I stayed awake the entire time.A night and wrote this for you. You know, many women die for my glance.Yet you stick to your old traditional marriage vows. Atu! Speak! Please, say something!
The lotus flower grow in the light of a firefly. You do not know of Rama's radiance. You are but an insect in comparison. Nor have you faced his arrows in battle.You clearly displayed your so-called might when you abducted me. Only, and only when I was all alone. To you, women are objects. But in the kingdom of Lord Rama, every woman is treated as a goddess.
Sita, you have offered me one too many insults. Have I not been a gentleman to you, waiting for your consent? Name me one king who has much wealth.As I do. You could have anything you desire.
The wise do not find happiness in material things. They find their joy looking within themselves.
Right, I'm getting tired of this.
Pleasures conceived in the world of the senses alone have a beginning and an end and eventually lead to misery. Nothing material is permanent happiness.And please, be honest. You are no gentleman. The real reason you have waited for my consent is because of your curse. That if you were to make love to one without her consent, you would burst into flames.
How do you know that? Who's been speaking behind my back? Speak up! Who told you this? How do you know this?
Who's been speaking behind my back? Speak up! I have given you too much luxury. You are my property now. You belong to me, do you understand? I should behead you here.
I do not fear you or your blade. Strike now, and you will only relieve me from my sorrow of being separated from my lord.
Oh, Ravana, there are many concubines for you to enjoy today. Why waste your time with her?
Security! You! Do what you will with Sita. In 1 month, if she doesn't accept me willingly, I will draw my sword again. And this time, her hand will lie at my feet, and so will all of yours! And so will yours!
Look, my husband's taken a liking to you. If you don't give in, he'll kill you. I don't understand. This kingdom has everything you'd ever want. It can make your dreams come true. Just say yes. That's all you have to do. Just give in. Just compromise.
This poor soul had endured a lot of sorrow, torment, and pain. I wanted to liberate her immediately so it didn't happen again. Right now, if I make any move, I put the mission and her at risk. I must be stealthy and wait until night so the task can be accomplished. These moments felt like the passing of an entire age. I couldn't wait to tell her of Rama, cheer her up, and then show these demons my rage.
Only 1 month left. Haven't forgotten me, have you? The once beautiful Supranaka, who any man would die for. Turned down by the handsome Rama for you. After what his brother did to me, watch and see what my brother Ravana would do to you.
To the very personification of nobility and righteousness, glory to Rama. Darling to his citizens and adhered to by many sages, glory to Lord Rama. Whose heart belongs to Princess Sita, glory to Lord Rama. Who now searches heartbroken for his beloved wife Sita, and sent this monkey to find her. Glory to Lord Rama.
Please don't fear me, Divine Mother. I came as Lord Rama's messenger.
I've never seen your Rama's kingdom. Who are you? How do you know my lord and his answer?
I have many names, but he calls me Hanuman. You may do also. Much has happened since you went missing. Now, armies of monkeys are in search parties spanning all corners of the earth, helping Rama find you.
Lord Rama? Search parties looking for me? Is it really true? My lord hasn't forgotten about me.
Divine Mother, I know it is hard to believe, but Lord Rama was confident I would be the one to find you, And so he gave me this ring to present to you as a token of trust.
Who is he? He must have been so distraught from my sudden disappearance.
By bodily health, he may look well, but I can barely begin to describe his distress being separated from you. He loves you twice as much as you love him. He asked me to deliver this message.
Sita, ever since I have been separated from you, everything has become its reverse. Fresh and tender leaves on trees look like fire, and the moon scorches like the sun. Lotuses look like spears, and fragrant breezes sound like hissing serpents. I long with all my heart to see you again.
Divine Mother, it brought much sorrow to my heart to see the pain in the eyes of King Rama. And now, after meeting you today, I cannot bear to see another in pain or being separated from their loved one. I wish I could take you back with me right now, but I see no practical way of doing so.
I'm so grateful for you. You've delivered me from my sorrows. However, I worry for the state of several other women like me. I do not wish to leave them as they are. I wish to wait for Lord Rama. He will help bring reform to the society.
Indeed, I have seen the state of women in this dark kingdom. Yet, you had the strength to fight back. Now that you have been located, I wait to see Rama's arrows fill these skies and wipe out these demons. I will ensure you and Lord Rama reunite soon. Just begin reciting his glories, and before you can be finished, we will be back.
Hanuman, I'm so pleased to have met you and to hear of my husband. But if I were to recite all his glories, it would take me years. Please don't make it that long. Here. Take this. You will know it is mine. May I ask, Hanuman, how do you know Lord Rama? What brought this alliance between man and monkey?
He came to us seeking for help. And my kind, we never turn anyone down. As you know, the rules state Rama is forbidden from entering any city. But I have witnessed myself how he doesn't need a kingdom to be king. He is a loving friend of the poor and treats all equally. All my monkey friends now serve him and will be ready to lay their life down for him.
Hanuman, have you seen how big and ferocious the people here are? Some apparently have battled beings on heavenly planets. I worry for yourself and your monkeys. Do you think you have the strength or experience in warfare?
Even Lord Yama, the god of death, shudders when he hears my name. I am sworn to help and protect those who come to me and those who pledge allegiance to Lord Rama. What you are about to witness now is just a teaser of what my army is capable of. Let me ensure no demon torments you again until I return with Lord Rama.
Once Ravan is done with Sita, who do you think he's gonna pass?
Hanuman, 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 Hanuman,
hope you all become better men in your next lives once I've crushed your filthy skulls.
I shall slay this beast and prove that I am Meganoth, son of Robin.
You and you, prove yourselves.
Don't you worry, it's not over yet. I purposefully fell to that weapon, as towards its creator, I have much respect.
Strip off his armor and take him to the king.
And how dare you injure my men? Have you not heard my name and trembled with fear?
I am here as the messenger of Lord Rama, Hanuman. Have you not heard my lord's name and trembled with fear? He who single-handedly defeated mighty tyrants, mightier than you.
Foolish monkey! You dare threaten me, the mighty Rama, with the name of a mere human being? Impotent monkey! I am not the least troubled by your provocations, nor by your Rama. Now, how dare you steal fruits from my garden and injure my men?
Funny, the theft of a mere fruit enrages you, yet you have no problem with righteousness to abduct human beings against their will.
How dare you?
Regarding your men, they attacked me with intention to kill. I attacked back. Self-defense, Ravana.
It's Lord!
Please, heed my advice. Return the Princess Sita to her rightful husband and give up your evil ways. Man is never beyond redemption. My king is compassionate. He will forgive you.
Really? I require the forgiveness of a mere human being?
You know, Ravana, if it wasn't for your ego, your sense of I, me, mine, you could be a great king, like Rama.
Ravana will be damned before he takes advice from a lowly monkey. Just who do you think you are? Do you not know where you stand? You have been caught by the great Rama.
Correction. You have not caught the messenger of Lord Rama. The messenger of Rama let himself be caught to get a good look at the fool who waged war with his mighty Rama. What I mean is, it is I who has captured you.
I will have you tortured and beheaded. Choose your words wisely.
Ha! Fool, there is no weapon on earth or any other heavenly planet belonging to any god that can harm you. I could finish you right now if I wished. But as a messenger, I would be insulting King Rama since I'm missing a mandate from him.
Kill this creature immediately!
Stop!
Forgive me, Your Grace. I'm sorry to interrupt, but it's against all statecraft to kill a messenger.
Vivisha, my brother, what good timing. What do you suggest that we do with him?
Well, you might be able to punish him, but we cannot kill him.
A monkey's tail is its most precious possession. If he were human, I would have defaced him such that he would not show his face again in a crowd. But as we're dealing with a monkey, how would he show his bottom to the rest of the pack? Bind his tail to rags and set it on fire! Ugh!
in your mind. I will make sure you're protected from it. You've proven yourself as a yogi and kept your vow of celibacy. I grant you the 8 supernatural powers and 9 abilities. Now arise. Remember your promise to Rama. Arise!
My dear friend, you are twice as dear to me as my own blood brothers. I know you'll be the one to find my beloved Sita. I trust in you. Remember how you shook the heavens as a mere child. Remember that title you once held, Great Sage, equivalent of heaven.
Slaves of arrogance! Is this all you've got? I'm sorry I failed you. Please spare my wives and daughters, please.
Ravana, I will leave you at the mercy of Lord Rama. Just know that I could have killed you today if he had permitted me. But my mission was only and only to locate Sita. But when I return with the mighty Rama, you better be ready to surrender.
Soon, Ravana will prepare for war. But at least for now, Sita wouldn't suffer anymore. As I watch the biting flames leave Sita untouched, I realize something which will be told through many ages to come. Sita wasn't the one being saved from Lanka. Lanka was the one being saved by Sita.